Stefanie Rouse.
And I'm Caleb Rouse.
And we are a husband and wife team. We work together full-time sharing about Jesus online and encouraging marriages. And we're very passionate about that as authors and bloggers, and getting to share with you today is such an honor.
Yes, it is. And today we're going to be talking about Jesus in the story of Christmas. And I want to read you this passage from Matthew 1, 18 through 25. And it says, "This is how the birth of Jesus the Messiah came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph. But before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, 'Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins.' All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet, 'The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel,' which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate their marriage until he gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus."
Christmas is Caleb and I's very favorite season because we love the fact that Jesus came to save us. And through this Christmas season, I really want to encourage you with something that I've been trying to do over the last, I don't remember how many Christmases, but our culture celebrates Christmas. And there is so much that points to Jesus that we sometimes might not be aware of. I know it's become a very commercial holiday and we can get defeated feeling like, where is this about Jesus? But lights were put up, not only because it was the darkest time of the year, but it's a reminder that Jesus is the light of the world. So as you go throughout neighborhoods and seeing lights lit up for Christmas, I want you to remember that Jesus is the light of your soul, the light of your heart.
And the beauty of those lights and Jesus being the light of the world is that he came to this place, this desolate place that needed a light. And he came in the most humble of circumstances, and he shone brightly, and he brought light to the darkness, and he revealed the sin that was in the world, and he became the sacrifice for that sin.
So powerful. We give away gifts at Christmas time, and so as we give them away, remember the most treasured gift that you've ever received, that Jesus came as a baby, but he came for a purpose, to die. And the reason he had to die is because it says in that scripture that he needed to save his people from their sins. We were completely unable to save ourselves. And that reminder that Jesus had to come because he wanted to save us. And he conquered death and sin forever. So every time that we can look at a gift, we can think back to Jesus. And I just hope and pray that in this Christmas season, it wouldn't necessarily be about all the commercial things, although it can be really fun, but to point us back to who Jesus is, that he is the gift. He is God with us, Emmanuel, and that he loves us beyond measure. He's the gift. He loves us so much, and that we can look at the lights, we can think to the gifts. When you hear the Christmas songs, listen for, like, hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn king. And listen to the words, listen to what that means for your life and your heart, and let the joy of Christmas fill you up like no material things ever could.
Yes, and I really want you to see the picture of Jesus, you know, almost like Santa. You know, Santa's paraded around and he's bringing these gifts to people. But what I love about the picture of Jesus almost as Santa is that when Jesus came, he sat with people. He sat there and heard the cries of their heart and the things that they wanted so deeply. And then he gave them that gift of his life as a sacrifice for our sins. And he sat with us in our moments of pain. He sat with us when we needed him the absolute most and gave us the hope and the light that is him. And what a powerful reminder just to think about as you go through this Christmas season that Jesus came here, he sits with us, he loves us, and he gives us that great gift.
Wow, that is so powerful to think of him. And Jesus is so much better than Santa.
Yes.
When you look at him, I love that, too, that Jesus sits with us, but the gift that he gives isn't just something that's going to be here today, gone tomorrow. It's the gift of forever salvation, forever being seen, forever being known by your Creator because He came and loves you. Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!